Hey guys, I'm Merrick, and welcome back to Let's Play Matrix Path of Neo.
What now, boy?
Your voice is really annoying, Merovingian.
The pawn has reached the endgame. Time to see if another piece is sacrificed and taken off the board. Choose carefully.
Well, this character is really annoying. Could I save none of them and kill all of them?
No matter. I was planning on deleting her anyway.
Another crow ripoff.
Choose quickly, boy. It's a simple challenge. Oh, that is,
if you are
truly the one, after all.
Okay, so we have to save the Banshee. The footage is pre-recorded, and I'm speaking over it. I haven't had to do that for a while. Just I'm doing it this way now because, haven't had the mic for a while recording, and I needed this level. It was seriously giving me.
No matter.
It was so bad. It's so difficult. It was bringing back my anger management issues, and I just decided it wasn't healthy. And I found it was better to listen to it without the sound. Not having to commentate on it live and listening to my own music, not the irritating sound the game makes. So, bullet stop and hurl objects aren't helpful. What you'll want to do is first, once she's going to take her stick out eventually. She has a stick in the second stage of the fight. Need to remember how to take that away. And I'm going back to this game at this point after three weeks of trying to play competently made games, trying to get myself back to not hating video games. Yeah, this game made me hate the medium. That's how bad it is. Every so often I take a few hits at the Banshee because he's just so goddamn irritating. You know, I should be taking a weapon off the wall, but now you know what, I'm gonna take a weapon. My favorite of the weapons, the longsword. I like the medieval, the chivalrous, and the knightly. It's a more elegant weapon from a more civilized age. The old times were civilized, right? The Banshee's not that bad in this stage, but in the next stage, she's so aggravating. I think I'll be putting a death reel of some of my previous attempts with some nice music after this, because I don't think just this is enough for a full-length episode. That'll be on. I don't know why I was having so much difficulty with this one before. It's pretty easy. It's just it's one of those irritating boss fights where there's a lot of running around. You're running from point A to point B, kinda like, have you ever played Ultima 2? The fight with Minax? This actually reminds me a lot of the fight with Minax. No more of her. I hate this character! And why is the Banshee not Irish?
No.
And why is she dressed like a moron? This isn't Rocky Horror Picture Show, put some clothes on.
Banshee's going down!
Okay, so, our goal here, because the stick isn't your thing, shut up!
Over here, Neo.
She talks to you during it, and she's really goddamned annoying.
Okay.
I was really in the zone of playing this because I was listening to AC/DC. I was kicking these characters' asses to Highway to Hell. And I'm gonna take your stick, smack the bitch with the stick. And I'm not saying bitch in a sexist way, I'm saying bitch as in... Well, one of them's trying to kill me, and the other one's just constantly nagging at me, berating me, and being generally unhelpful while I'm trying to protect her for some reason. She's about as worth saving as Princess Peach at this point. In some of the attempts, I just get fed up and kill her, because it's very satisfying. Oh, shut the fuck up. By the way, that little green thing around her, that is a, it can stun you, and she'll take you. But she can't take a weapon after you take away her stick. The fight's going well, I'm just gonna get one more weapon. More than that, I think. I don't know. Can't remember. Oof. Oh god, can you imagine how bad the movie... I mean, the movies already suck, but can you imagine how bad they would be if the Banshee was actually in them? Holy shit, they'd have their own Jar Jar! Shut up.
Over here, Neo.
I've realized in my other attempts that I'm focusing too much on the game itself or trying to do things that look cool because it's a let's play. I actually got to a point in this one where I'm not even looking at the screen. I'm just ignore the game and you will win the game, kind of. By the way, you lost the game.
Yeah,
I'm still making that a thing. Kick. Kick again, kick. So how are all of you? Leave something in the comments saying how you're liking the Let's Play so far. It's nearing its close, thank Christ. I actually went on GOG recently and picked up a few things, and I might be Let's Playing them, some of them in the future. There's Call of Cthulhu Dark Corners of the Earth that I got, which is great. Evil Dead Hail to the King, which is Resident Evil with likable protagonists, because they replaced Chris and Jill with fucking Ash Williams, which is great. Seriously, the user interface, the entire engine of the game is Resident Evil. It's kind of amazing. The other one is I Have No Mouth and I'm a Scream, which you may notice I did the culture and shit of it some time ago. And slightly screwed up one of the lines half an hour in, so I was just like, fuck it, it stays in. Because I made the mistake of doing the whole thing one take. We're at the part now, actually, where I give up looking at the screen and just basically let the force guide me to win this fight. Like, Luke, going down the trench of the Death Star. Luke, use the force, Luke. And then he closes his eyes and manages to hit the thing. And that's what this was like for me. That Iron Maiden blasting and playing in the background. You got, it was Rhyme of the Ancient Mariner.
Water, water everywhere, and all the boats that shrink.
of water everywhere, nowhere to drop to dream. Like relaxing music. And then... Oh, shit.
No more torture!
You are my torture. And your constant shrieking, irritating voice. Kick, kick, punch. That was one of my favorite combo. Oh, and the heal others at men principle? Only one worth the damn. I'll have you know. Yeah, if you couldn't tell by some of the things I posted, I'm a huge Evil Dead fan. I think I said that in the Pirates of the Caribbean Let's Play. I mean, Escape from New York may be one of my favorite movies, but you know how some people are Star Wars fans, and then there are Star Trek fans, and all that? I'm an Evil Dead fan. I own the comics, now I own all the games. I couldn't find the original for a while because it's really hard to find, so I had to buy it through GOG. Have the musical, have toys of it, it's great. I made fan art of it, I made a chainsaw hand. I love Evil Dead with a passion. And I used to love Star Wars with a passion, but then it started prequels and altering the originals and ruining them, and changing fundamental aspects of the story, fundamentally changing Han Solo's character, unnecessary CGI, which, well, that's what I call The Matrix, actually, unnecessary CGI, and just, it's actually kind of sad that I can't call myself a Star Wars fan anymore because of all the shit that's in Star Wars. I know people joke about Jar Jar, and they joke about Jar Jar Binks being the worst Star Wars thing in Phantom Menace, but he's just the icing on the cake. There is so much shit wrong in the prequels. There's so much betrayal in those movies. But I'll get to those if I ever do a Let's Play of a Star Wars game. You're dead, and, you're not. Can I kill you?
The Merovingian was wrong.
Stop talking.
Much better than the other ones. We'll see each other.
Oh again. God, no, no, please, God, no! I don't want to see you ever again. Don't. Well. Can't kill her, unfortunately. And, yeah. That was the level that almost undid all of anger management. That's how bad that level was. Heal others is the only really worth a damn Atman principle. And, yeah, so, leave you with that shitty thing they put into this game, and, I'll see you next time. I'm just going to stay, if you want to, stay and watch the death reel. And, yeah, I'll see you there.
Let's have a party, there's a full moon in the sky. It's the hour of the wolf and I don't wanna die. I'm so happy dancing while the grim reaper cuts, 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 but he can't get me.
I'm as clever as you can be and I'm very quick, but don't forget we've only got so many tricks.
No one lives forever.
Shining.
Hey guys, I hope you just enjoyed that video. This has been edited, played, and recorded by me, Merrick D'Amato. All art was by Ann Rogers, and hope you enjoyed this one. Hope to see you for the next one. And please like, subscribe, maybe leave a comment if you like. I'll try to respond to any really interesting comments I get. So, ciao.